More than 20 veterans take their own life every single day in our country. Governor Gary Herbert says it's an epidemic we must get ahead of, and it will take all of us working together.
The transition from a war zone to civilian life isn't easy. Ernest Mayo knows that firsthand. After returning from Vietnam, he established a successful career in law enforcement and was actively involved in the community. In June of 1992, it all came crashing down.
I lost my job, lost my career, you know, I lost my sense of direction. I lost everything.
Mayo was watching television one night when he lost control.
In my mind, I was in Vietnam. I was reliving a mission in the Yashaw Valley.
He set booby traps around the neighborhood, led sheriff's deputies on a chase, and even fired shots at them. He was diagnosed with combat-related post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD, and was committed to a mental health facility. Dr. Stephen Allen coordinates the PTSD clinic at the Salt Lake VA. He says military experiences present many challenges for returning veterans.
Veterans that have been on deployment are changed, that their experiences are changed, and they're actually their family at home has changed over the course of the year. So that presents significant readjustment issues for many families.
Nearly half of the 2.2 million troops deployed in Iraq and Afghanistan report difficulties on their return home. Dr. Allen says signs of PTSD include problems with temper, relationships, sleep, and continual thoughts of traumatic military events. He says the VA can help with drug abuse, anxiety, PTSD, and more.
It's the strong veterans that are able to say, I need some help and I want to address this issue and get this taken care of. Our role is to be there and provide that help for them.
Unfortunately, available help isn't reaching everyone. 22 veterans commit suicide in our country every day.
That's unconscionable. We need to do everything we can to help them.
Mental health, specifically that of our veterans, weighs heavy on the mind of Governor Gary Herbert.
All of us, probably everybody, knows somebody, family, friend, that in fact has committed suicide and the devastating effects it has on those loved ones left behind.
And all of us need to be part of the solution.
One group alone won't solve the problem. It's not only the federal government, it is also the state government. It's also the private sector.
The state is taking a two-part approach to help veterans transition. Career training and employment opportunities are provided through the Department of Workforce Services. Counseling and other mental health resources are available through the Department of Human Services. It's about breaking down the barriers of stigma and embarrassment that keep us from talking about it. Mayo says opening up helped him.
Life today is wonderful.
To this day, he still has triggers that take him back to the war, but he's learned how to control it. Now he's helping others do the same as a certified peer specialist at the VA. Connecting with veterans who are struggling with PTSD as someone who has walked a mile in their shoes.
I can take something awful, take something evil, and use it for something good.
Governor Herbert says his alternative to Medicaid expansion, the Healthy Utah Plan, is another solution. He says it's an overall approach to physical, mental, and economic health and would provide people with the coverage and assistance they need to get help in all three areas. He has federal approval on the plan and is now working to get the state legislature to sign off on it. In studio, Glenn Mills, Good for Utah.